everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and today I'm coming to share with you hopefully a long time project. You can see pictures, photographies from that final project I made in this process video. I found on my bookshelf a book which I've got for a very long time and I didn't read it before, but because right now I feel like I want to read it because I need some advices. I opened that book and it came to my mind, why do not alter it? That book, it's a little bit different than normal books. You will see that once I will open the treasure box, I choose to keep those final projects in it. You can see that now. The name of that book, it's The Secret. It's supposed to be something like helper or advisor, how to become a master of your life. And I would like to be one. I would like to be master of my life, which I'm not. So I was thinking, I'm gonna read that book, and alongside of that, I will try to alter every single page with any advice. There is 365 pages with advices, how to deal with situations in your life, how to think positively, how to manage your life. And some of those advices are amazing, really amazing. So I hope that I will enjoy it and I hope you will enjoy it as well. always I will take just one page and I will try to do something. What can be called like inserts for journals. Because as you know, I love to do books. I love to do journals, notebooks, lab books. And I was thinking, how many inserts, how many types of inserts, how big, how many inserts we can do. And in this long time run, I will try to do as many as my brain will imagine. And I hope that every single one will be different. I hope I will don't do some design many times. And I really hope that I will enjoy it and you will enjoy it. So for first my project, I chose Czech Republic. You know, I am from Czech Republic, so that was obvious that I have to choose this theme. I miss my country so much. I miss my family, my friends. So I chose Czech Republic like first, not theme, but like helper. Those ephemeras are from Czech Republic. They are very old ephemeras I've got in my stuff. There are deposit papers, train tickets, train legitimation for, you know, when you're traveling monthly. There is, I think, some advert from Baťa Shoes. He was a very, very famous businessman in the past. I think there is, I don't remember everything, but I did one postcard and I used the image of Saint Venceslav. Saint Venceslav is like patron of Czech Republic, Saint patron of Czech people and Czech Republic. That's why I made that postcard with him in my digitals. Also, all digitals I will choose for those projects, they will be on my Patreon page for public, so you don't have to be afraid to go there and have a look. Those images and those ephemeras I will use in those projects in this altering the secret, they will be on my Patreon page for public, so go to have a look. As I said, I was thinking I will do some inserts, and for that first one I thought, because I love file folders, I thought I will do some like normal file folder with those tabs, but then in that process I change it a little bit. You will see that I used old book pages, and I used also a few of my offcuts because that's the way I do work. I'm trying to use envelopes, book pages, and so many offcuts I've got from previous projects. So you will see that layering, and I used also red cardstock, 300 grammage red card. You can see that now. And I use this cardstock for pockets I created for this journal. I wanted to create some kind of pattern, so I chose pencil this time and scissors. No any dies, no any some special tools. I was thinking, why not? More tools I have, the less I am creative. Really, I love my tools. I love everything I have, but sometimes I feel that more tools I am using, that imagination or that creativity, it's not same like I had while ago when I had only scissors and the ruler. I was thinking how to fold this one, how to cut it. So I will try always to use not so many tools. I will use my tools, that's why I bought it, but I will try to also alter some way how to cut things, how to decorate things. And here you saw how I created that decorative edge for my folder. And it was really good to go like to history of cutting. I used also file folder in this project. I decorated with that file folder, embossing file folder, not file folder, embossing folder. Oof. This embossing folder I used, I embossed both of these red cardstock. And normally I'm just decorating that embossed effect with distress ink. I'm using Won't Stain distress ink from Ranger, from Tim Holtz Ranger, because it's my favorite. I will talk about my favorite things, of course, also. So I used Walnut Stain for distressing that embossed effect. But then I was thinking it's a little bit darker than I wanted. So I was thinking, why do not use some highlighter? And I chose Posca Pen, which I know it's great. I know about this Posca Pen from Marta's channel, from Maremismo Art. She's using that Posca Pen, so I bought that Posca Pen. And I can say that it's a really good one. It does that work I want. So I highlight the edges of that embossed effect, and I can say that I'm very, very satisfied with that result. That was amazing to see how that embossed effect is changing, how it's like pop up on that piece of cardstock. So I use that Posca Pen also on that second piece. You will see that later. And I chose to use those red pieces like my pockets. I glued them, and then I used my sewing machine, because sewing machine as a tool with papercraft is so amazing, really so amazing. I showed my sewing machine a while ago. I bought on eBay a small mobile machine. It's very small, it's not too big. It has 12 different stitches, and it didn't cost too much, so I'm very satisfied with this purchase. And now, because now I just don't know what to say else about my crafting here, my creating that project, so I will try to talk about my favorite tools. I do have lots of emails and messages about this one, about this theme, or this, yeah, about my tools. And I was thinking I will say what it's my favorite. So that sewing machine, it's a really good purchase. That was really good shopping, that sewing machine. I will also try to find the tools I bought. I will talk about them now, and I will put some links down below to the description box, so you can see which tool I mean. So one of those favorites, it's my sewing machine. Another which I'm using every single day, it's Paper Guillotine from Tim Holtz. It's from Tonic Studios. Paper Guillotine, I love that tool. I love this this Paper Guillotine, it's really wonderful. So that is one of my favorite. Another favorite, it's Crocodile, which I bought. It's that bigger one. It's Crocodile 2. It's with that larger arm, so you can punch the holes, and you can fixed eyelets even in the middle of your big page, which I really like this opportunity. and one of most surprising and happy shopping was when I've been waiting 2 years, and I've been thinking for 2 years, if I need an envelope punch board, do I need that? I don't need that. 2 years. I was thinking this way, then I bought it, and I was thinking why I didn't buy it before. Why I was so silly and I didn't buy it before. I can promise you, if you like journals with tabs, with like decorative notches in pockets, go to buy this tool. I bought envelope punch board from VR Memory Keepers, and I am so happy I did it. Really, it's envelope tool. And then from VR Memory Keepers, I bought also trim and scoreboard. I'm using it every day as well. But there is but. This tool, it's not wrong, but it has things. If I will know them before, I will choose different scoreboard and different trimmer. That scoring board, it's foldable. That's why I thought it will be wonderful, because you don't need big space. But mistake happens that fold, it's on 5.5 and 5 5/8, exactly between those two score lines. And not always it's easy to score. If you need to score 5.5, it's sometimes jumping to that fold. You know, it's not the perfect. I use that tool all the time. I can live with that. But if I will know this small thing, I will probably choose just big, full, massive 12x12 scoring board. It will be probably less stressful. And also knives on this trimmer and scoreboard, they are not too sharp for a long time. They're going out really fast. So that's it's another thing. And the most amazing shopping I ever did, it was my Sizzix Big Shot. I've got that Sizzix Big Shot Plus, where you can use also a normal size of letter papers, that A4 size of letter paper. So it's a really big machine, and it's amazing. I love that machine so much. I can only recommend this machine. I had before that smaller one, that blue, beautifully blue with flowers. I had that before. It was amazing as well, but I always wanted to do some bigger pieces, you know, some cutting and embossing bigger pieces and bigger cardstock. That's why I bought this bigger one, that Sizzix Big Shot Plus, and I am so happy about that. As a glue, you saw that in this video already a few times, I'm using Anita's Tacky Glue. It's amazing tacky glue. I can only recommend that glue. I bought that glue on Amazon because I found that glue on Amazon for a really good price. They don't have it anymore for that good price. But still, that glue, it's really wonderful. So I can only say yes for that glue. And what else? Yeah, I love to use coffee and tea. For coffee dyeing and tea dyeing my book pages, as you saw that right now. So I can only recommend that coffee and tea are amazing for edging your pages. That's wonderful. If you don't like smell, very strong smell of dried pages with coffee, don't do it. Use only tea, because coffee, when it's dry, those pages when are dry, that coffee smells really, it's strong smell. And if you don't drink coffee, maybe that smell will be not for you. So use tea. But really, tea and coffee for edging papers, it's wonderful, wonderful. So this is about tool. I think what else, I'm not sure what else to say. About metal stuff, yeah, I had many times questions about metal stuff I'm using, about those brads and any kind of metal stuff I'm using in my project. I don't have some special shop where I am shopping. I do buy those eyelets and those bigger ones. Grommets, I think it's grommets, something like grommets. it's that right word. I do buy them on eBay from eBay something. It's shop, but it's English shop, so it's just for. They don't say send internationally. They are English shop, but they've got good stuff. But I don't have any, you know, only one shop where I am buying this metal stuff. I'm always just going to have a look, and what I see, like, first one mostly I'm buying, and then I am surprised when it comes in different different amount, because I didn't read that properly. So I don't have any, like, a special shop I'm shopping, not at all, just, you know, Amazon and eBay. That's only I can say. Yeah, what else I wanted to talk about? Right now you can see, oh yeah, another question. Now when I see that pizza box, I do have many questions. How many household items I'm using? Many, all the time. Pizza boxes, cereal boxes, all the time, really. Toilet paper rolls. Those things around you, in your house, they are the most useful things you can have. Used tea bags. Really, pizza boxes, you can see that now. I'm using so many things. Also, yeah, now when I saw that sanding block, it's another wonderful tool I'm starting to use more and more for more and more things. That's another tool I love to use. Yes, sanding block. But from household items, I'm using nearly everything, really. I'm using can openers, like decorative elements, like paper clips, like embellishments. I'm using empty milk bottles for embellishments, especially for Bix, Sizzix Bix dyes. These are the deeper dyes where you can use also cardstock, chipboard, leather, metal, plastic. Those dyes are cutting really so many different things. That's why I love them. Any kind of those Bix dyes I love, because they are really wonderful. And for them, I can choose actually most of threshold items, like those empty milk bottles. I use them for those light bulbs from Tim Holtz, and they was wonderful, really. And in this project, you will see that really soon. I'm using also a teaspoon, but that idea, it's not mine. I was Googling how to use, how to alter teaspoon, because I broke one teaspoon. I tried to open jar with teaspoon, and it didn't go well. I ended with closed jar and with spoon on two pieces. So I saved that spoon because I was thinking maybe I will find a way how to use it in my craft. And I went on Pinterest. And if you never typed to Pinterest, teaspoon art, go to try it. I promise you, my, how you say that, my jaw dropped. My mouth dropped down, really, when I saw those art, those altered spoon, altered forks. I couldn't even breathe. That was totally amazing, how amazing artists are in the world. I didn't understand how they can even came up with those ideas. There was bracelets, there was rings made from spoon. Really, rings made from forks. Oh, guys, if you never try to have a look on this type of art, please go to have a look on Pinterest and type there teaspoon art. Amazing. Or altered teaspoon. Really amazing. And now you can see, sometimes I forget to tea dyed or coffee dyed the papers, so you can always do it. Yeah, and another tool I love to use is this heating tool. wonderful things when you need to heat something. Once was visiting me my friend, not crafter at all, and I went shopping, and she had a bath through that time when I've been shopping. And when I came home, she told me, "You've got a very strong hair fan." And I was staring at her because I didn't had at that time any hair fan, hair dryer, that is that right word. She used this heating tool for her hair. And I was so scared. I told her, "Oh my God, you could burn your head." So that heating tool, it's probably useful also for your hair. Please don't try it. Don't do it. It's too hot. But that is another tool I love to use. Heating tool, that's a wonderful tool. And now I was thinking how I will decorate that dress. I think I was already wanted to add all those ephemeras, so I just made a very small decoration, very easy decoration, just small layout. And what else? I've got in those questions. Oh, lately, you know, I'm living in England. And here in England, it's now very, very big theme that Brexit. It's a big theme not just for British people, for English people. It's a bigger theme for all people from not England. I'm not sure how to say that right. Not some vulgarism. I'm not sure if abort people or foreign people, I don't want to say it wrong, but you know who I mean. So many questions I've got now. If I want to go back home just because Brexit, no. I want to move back to Czech Republic, yes, of course I want. But it's just because my parents are not getting younger. We had so many bad experiences with their health this year. And I'm missing my family so much, and you know, I just feel that it will be only right to be close to them. And next question I had a few times lately, it was related to this theme that if I will don't feel bad that. How it was there that it was like why I moved to England in that theme, why I moved to England, if it was for money or for what. No, it wasn't for money. I had a really good job back in my country. I had a flat back in my country, so it wasn't for money. I've been a welder back in Czech Republic, and welders, I think, in everywhere in the world, they always have good wages, so I wasn't bad in my life. I felt in love, guys. I felt in love with a guy who was living in England, and I didn't know he's living in England. He was from Slovakia, and his brother was boyfriend of my best friend, and we met. I felt in love. And when I found that he's living in England, I tried to force him to move to Czech Republic. But he didn't want. We've been for long distance relationship for 2.5 years. For all that time, I tried to force him to move him to Czech Republic. He didn't want. We've been visiting each other many times. And he was amazing with my boys. And when he said, "You should move to England with the boys," yeah, I moved to England with boys. But then, you know, when you are not thinking properly, he wasn't ready for family, for not everyday party life. So it didn't go well, and I stuck here. Because we already left everything back in Czech Republic. I haven't there any job, I haven't there any flat to live in. My son was already signed up here at school, so it was much more easy to stay here and continue the life here, even if it wasn't easy at all. I haven't friends here, I haven't family here, and I didn't speak English at all. only I knew at that time it was yes, no, sorry, I don't understand. I'm tourist only. That's what I learned to be sure that people will not feel that I am some widow. So I learned this sentence. I'm sorry, I don't understand. I am just tourist. That's what I said to everyone. I remember that. It was a horrible time. But I can say that English people are very, very polite, really. They were so helping with my start of learning English. They are always, always very happy to help me. So I love England. I really do. England is it's a wonderful country. What I don't like in England, and now please, if you are from England, don't take it wrong. What I don't like, it's the food here. It's totally different, really, really. I'm so sorry. I do like there is one food, one food. Chopped pork, I think chopped pork, but just from one shop, one fast food here has amazing chopped pork. That's amazing, but all that rest, it's, I don't know, it's not what I like. My sons don't mind, they eat everything, they are good with that, but probably for me it's not the right taste, but it's only thing I'm not preferring here. It's not like I hate it or so, no, not at all, but I just have different taste, that's it, but it's only thing. And sometimes I don't like that it's so many days rain, but this year it wasn't bad at all. It was really good. That's only thing, yeah. And I don't like if I don't know how to explain things, but I'm telling you, English people are amazing with this thing. All you guys, really, you're amazing to helping me out when I don't know. And when I'm thinking so hard, and especially if you will stand up front of me and you will see my face, you will see how I am concentrating. How is that word? I know that word. And you can see that on my face. So, mostly my post office lady, she is nearly crying when she see me, but not from sadness. She's crying from laughing, from not to laugh to my face. How I am trying to think so hard. So I'm telling you, English people are amazing. Yeah, and here you can see that spoon. Yeah, this is that spoon I broke few weeks ago, and I saved that spoon, and now you will see what I made with that spoon. I made charm with that one half. That other half I will use for something else. I will again go to Pinterest and I will try to find some amazing art, because there is really so many. This folding or curving that edge, it took a really long time. I cut that process really, I cut it a lot, because it took quite a long time. I also tried to heat it up, but heating tool didn't go well too much. But I end up with that hole on the end. And here you can see. Yeah. So I was too happy. I was so happy I did it this way. I was so happy I found that altered spoon on Pinterest. So if you never saw some altered spoons, forks, guys, go to have a look. Those arts made from spoons and forks and knives, they are totally amazing. And I don't know what to say else. Probably not. So I guess till the end of this video, because there is nothing too much what I did, there will be only fitting ephemeras some way, and that's it. So till the end of this video, I will put some nice music, and I hope you will enjoy that rest of this video. Thank you so much for sharing your time with me today. I hope you enjoyed my mumbling and also that process. Oh yeah, now I will put some beautiful music, because now you will see my drawing. And the word I chose as a first one, which was the most important in my life, to find that.
So you will see what I always try to find for anything in my life. And I hope that mostly I found it. So thank you so much for sharing your time with me today. I hope you will enjoy the rest of this video. And see you next time. Bye.